Okay, so today is to carry on with the importer, finish up the rest of the importation, get everything kind of working fine. The initial implementation refinements I can kind of figure out next time for both the exporter and importer and some other surrounding systems. But for now, I need to get the rest of the initial implementation done. So, start with is last time we finished up dependencies. So this time it's the index and resource data. The index data, I should say. And then the resource and index data, or resource and component data, then the files. So let's see what we got. This get group entity index data. So it's something like this and this. Okay, that makes sense. All right. What do we got? What do we got? Get that and that. So that's going to be the binary data, binary importer, and that and that. We're going to have two things. We need the data, it's the starting point. So I need to offset and data size. Okay, so. The importer file header dot the start point for the entity data offset is there. That goes to resource data offset minus this. And then we have the indexes data. Yeah, makes sense. Okay. Got a similar thing kind of going on over here. So to begin with, key importer resource index data file header dot entity index data minus dot resource index data offset. Okay. And then we kind of need something like this. Now, F open for. Okay, you know what? I just passed them. Do I actually want to pass it in? No. I need to. The importer F. String. I just just pass the path straight up right now. Standard file system path indexes, that's great. Path dot string dot c string read binary. Dot p file. It's not open, then binary failed open file. Not very useful, is it? So how did I export this stuff? ECS export indexes, okay. So we have o id index then Okay, yeah, so it's first you get 4 bytes for that, then we get 32T index count. So first of all is fread Next index. Size of OID index times 1, file. Oh, right. Need these things. So actually, after that, I need to fseek to from key file to the offset from the set. Then I need to read that. And I want to assert that size equals however much I kind of read. So it'd be this. Then F read and three index count, which is a uint 8t, is it? No, it's a uint 32. P file. And comes fread. Faux ID index star. If. Free index count greater than 0. Then I need to do p free indexes equals malloc of size, which is count and size of OID index. That plus that. The recycled count, which is E132, great. Yeah. So I need to say, you know, this is a faux ID index star that. Okay. If we didn't allocate that, then I need to say, hey, you know, I failed this because this is. Oh, results, error out of memory. I also need to close up the file. Size equals plus and size of OID index. Otherwise, f read e free indexes size of o id index times free index count p file. Then at this point, I want to import what's going on here. ECS indexes, okay, great. I need to do that. Indexes, next, index, index count, free indexes. Okay, so that's those two. Maybe can I actually test that out here? So ECS indexes. Resource index data. Test. I need to create it, of course. Okay, group zero, test. If that abort, group the index data, okay. Okay, oh, yep. Go inside. It's great. We go inside. Do, 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 do. Yes, 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 yes. I get it. I get it. I get it. Offset of 60, size of whatever. Because if I go back up by one, the importer file 60 and 68 and 8 each. Yep. Okay. File is real. We're seeking to the offset in the file. So next index is 1. Was it? We kind of approach this from the other side. First, let me actually see the data that's going in so I can see what's coming out. So next new index is 1, there's a second count of 0, and then there's 1. Let's see. That can't be right. Okay, I'll assume it is for the moment. This is for the data A, right? Right. Persistent resource indexes. Okay, so this could actually be very real. What is the persistent? The data persistent. 4 and 1. Okay, yeah, see, that's wrong. That's not what I'm looking for. Something is wrong in here. Export index data. resources, and then okay, the entity index data. There you are. It helps to actually get the right information in the first place, shall we? Let's go. Okay. Four, recycled count of zero. Okay, that's great. So now back on the other side, this side. Come inside of here. No. Here. Whatever, don't care. One, and then very not right. Okay, offset for this one is very wrong. How did you get in here? Index data offset. Resource is from that to the entity index data offset. This is up to index data to resource data. Entity index data offset. These are reversed for some reason. Okay. One zero, nothing. 40 something. Okay. Let me make a little bit of a change here. I'm going to say, hey, there is actually 5 6. 5 6. Like that. Show me that I can do some basic programming today, please. Great, 1 0. We've got two empty ones, which are 5. And I presume if I hit P, the index is 1 6. What? No, it should have been 4 and 5. That's my bad. But that does work. Okay. Great, and I presume that's not failing, right? Okay, yeah, it gets through the thing. It's not actually saying that I'm deleting the importer. Interesting. Is it just I don't have an actual thing for deleting? I have a message for creating it, but not for destroying it. I'm destroying this, and then I need another one that says, you know, it's been destroyed, but of course I won't have the name anymore to put out, so I just do destroyed, which is just the one. I can add this to the other import, that'd be great. So I can actually tell when that's being destroyed too, in a verbose manner. Destroy. There you are. Again, that's another small refinement. There's a lot of small refinements like that I gotta do. So that's those two. Now it's getting the actual data. Input resource definitions, state data. I have these in reverse order. Why? And of course, yeah, the names I don't have exported. So. Import state data is the next one, I guess. Fine. First of all, this, then we get the stuff to open the file, please. I wonder if I change this up. Sometime, string C string. I'm thinking of actually changing like the file rather than opening and closing the file a whole bunch of times, especially when I'm going to be reading for resources. I'm thinking of memory mapping, but I'm not the again a refinement that I'm not going to get to today. Just random stuff. Okay, so we're not here, we're not doing this. How do I do this? This. Okay, that's that stuff, which I don't have access to quite yet. Set result equals two for result. Success, okay. I'm just going to go through it like sequentially, aren't I? Reading one at a time. Okay, getting the importer functions. So I have that. I'm going to need some functions. So how does this work? Do I just pass back the where is it? This. So this is going to be this, where this is going to have to be, and then I need, so I need to include that, get those, brilliant. Then I need these function declarations, that, and that. That and that. So it's not that, it's a string view. Now I can use those in here. It's a seek to from p file p importer file header dot file data offset entity data offset from seek set. Read size equals total read size. File header dot entity file data dependency resource entity data offset. Entity data is the last data, so that goes to the file data offset. Minus this. All right. Let's close things to the right. First is the type index. Sorry, I'm looking at the wrong thing. Component export data resource data. No, that's putting it into the data stuff. When I actually write it out, I got the binary key. Component binary key index. So first of all is the number of bytes. So 16T. Indices are in indexes. Indices is defined as the same as indexes in a particular case, but only there. Binary key count. There we go. We'll F read that. One empty file. That's great. Okay, we got that. Now I want to, I don't even know the length of these keys. Ooh. I just assumed it would always be the same and I never actually wrote it out or what? Yeah, Okay, I need to write that out. I need to write out the key length. To here. what is this, size T first. Okay, it's that, it's great. Whatever, 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 whatever. 16P, let's just do that. Keep it simple, that, okay. This is going to increment by 2 bytes. One P file. Got this going again. That's great. Okay. Now I need to create a number of key things. So what is this? C++, so I can do a standard vector of standard string. Binary keys. Would it be this? Or no? Times, I guess, internally. I'll read the key, I'll read the index, then I put them in the map for the moment. Map. So for each of these, we're going to do two things. First of all, it's the index, then the key. Index key, okay. Key dot resize for key length. Read the key, sorry, the index. There has to be a better way than this. But I don't know what it is right now. Key file. Rather than having a second, like two index kind of system, I gotta be able to fall back to using the structure, you know, the structure type 4-byte thing. Just passing that around, I think. That would probably be better than these keys, especially if we're going across the network. Going, you know, in the file, not so bad, but across the network, I need something that's speedier, easier, and faster to do comparison mappings for. That's for sure. But anyways, fread key.data Key length, one, rather it's 1 byte times key length. File. About that, key lengths. Yeah, that should give us all the keys. No, there's. I'm looking at this the wrong way, aren't I? Index a key. Yeah. I hit upon an index that I wrote out. Then I find the key. Then I match that key to the import function. Then I run from there. That's how this is going to have to roll. So, okay, got that. I got that. Got that information out. Great. Now read. Int data. So, while total data size not equals 0, keep reading stuff, I think. Should be that, the data size. So index, data size, data. Okay. Don't actually have, so it's just until while total data size greater than 0, basically. Great. I just need a large buffer. That's going to be very, very large. Per byte basis times data size up from heap file. Okay, that's how it's going to be. We got that. We got the data back out. Now I need to actually, right, total data size. Okay. Back to the importer. We got that stuff. So now it's kind of the case of get the key. Key equals component functions dot find for the key index. Index. Operator equals key map dot find. There's definitely a way to shortcut this later, for sure. There will be. This is way too janky and convoluted. Definitely, it has that feel to it. Regardless, key index. Index search operator equals. With that problem, abort real. Equals. Component functions dot find based on the index search iterator dot second, which is the key. If that, we gotta roll abort. Otherwise, this is the point where we then do. Search iterator. Second, which will be the dot. What is it? Import search iterator for the. Import, no, yeah, there's only the one function for this. Okay, yeah. Then we got it, yeah, then we're into this stuff. So we got the buffer, the data size, the, I'm gonna make sure that these match. You pass that in. We got a group. Translator, I don't know. Oh, P importer, okay. Group translator, if it has one. The entity, I don't know what I just have the data. I don't actually have the entity information. Okay. So, if I'm doing this per thing, how would this work? So, what I'd have to do is on the export side, you got this, then the resource data each resource. No. Not great. I'm trying to think, like, how do I want to export this stuff? Because I lose that information. Like, I'm just kind of going to export this data, then I just kind of do it internally. I'm just passing back a bunch of blank data. And I don't necessarily want to attach the entity or the resource ID to each data set, because there can be multiple components or multiple resource or multiple files per ID, which is wasteful, overly wasteful. All right, I need to take a break. I need to think on this. I need to think on this. So, okay, I think I've got it. I'm going to have to, when I export a resource, I have resource ID already. This is also going to be the location where I can actually put down the name. So, what I'm thinking is I don't actually have to export the resource ID or the resource name, do I? Right, because if I go into here, actually use it. Oh, I do. Cool. But I don't use the resource name, right? Okay. Right, so this is how it's going to roll instead. I'm going to have, okay, exporter. Go down to here, roll back up to wherever this is called. And then we're going to have something that's along the lines of resource data sets. Okay, here we go. Vector, we're going to have a little struct type in here. Resource set, I guess I'll call it. So this is what? Oh no. Yes? No, maybe. Yeah. That and the standard string of the name, if it has one. And int32t. Data sets as a count. So resource set. Resource sets, and what we're going to do is we're going to pass that in to here. Going to have, okay, this needs to be set up way up here. Whoops. Control X that, bring it all the way up here, please, and thank you. Resource set, that's great. Let's go to resource data. Standard vector of resource set. Star of the sets. Ah, get out of here. Okay. Do 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 do. We're down here. If not equal that, then what we would want to do is p resource sets. Place back. Set. Dot ID equals resource ID. Dot name equals. Like, how many did I actually set? I don't know how many I set. Okay, maybe I passed that in. Binary sets. Sets. Resource is here. Okay. Get that. Do I put it in here instead? So that I only put out data when there's actual B resource sets in place back. ID dot name equals name dot sets equals one. Okay, we have that, and then we need to do the same thing for component entities. So resource set and struct entity set. Rolling on down to here for the entities, so I still want to have this in one larger thing, I think. Maybe not. Oh man, like this, like again, okay, whatever, right? I can refine this later. I need to get the actual thing to actually work first. So the resource sets, entity sets. So we're doing basically kind of the same thing. We get to this point, p simulation, entity sets. Go up here. The entity sets, that's great. Then up here. I need to kind of set if. I need to say, like, okay, size T or whatever. Equals 0. Plus, plus that. And only if. What? Oh, yeah, if it's not a success, it'll return that instead. That's fine. So P entity sets place back and set the ID dot name equals P entity name dot data sets equals exported components. Shrink it down. Okay, so we get a number of things. So, with that data available, that then means what we want to do is rolling on back down to the point where we're actually exporting this data. Or, okay, I'm a little lost. Resource data right here. So we've got the binary key stuff. Okay, yeah, here we go. Okay, how does this work? I need to have two different sets of iterators. So Resource iterator equals stats dot begin auto iterator equals resource data sets dot begin okay no I just need one don't I Almost equals data. Each data resource set I'm going through, and I've got to go like four. Okay, first of all, resource. I said, dang it. Okay, first of all, we're doing like F, right? So I need auto const and set equals yes, I. So it's set dot ID. Source ID. One. EL file. We get that. Then I need, what was it? The name, which is a string. So it's two things. It's a string length and then the So, total data written is resource ID, source name, editor name. F write set dot name dot size. So I can't do that. It has to be un32t string length equals this. That string length, size of that. This if string length is greater than 0, and we also f write out name itself. So set dot name dot data string length on. File or it's one time string length. Oh, so total written data becomes size of that plus length. Okay. Associated resource APIs. So I need to UN32T. I already actually have that. F right. Set dot data sets. Size of UN32T. One EL file. Then, so that's incremented by that. Four. J is zero. J is less than set of data sets. Plus plus J. Doing this. Times the number of whatever. This isn't quite that. This is actually the data iterator. So rather than that, it should be plus plus data iterator. Okay. So I need to data iterator point. That. Okay. All right. I think that is it. Okay. This is after the binary key. So it's the binary key, then the per resource stuff. So, while total data size is greater than zero, I can't do the key index. This is the per component section. Entity. I need to F read and entity size of the ID. Sorry, resource ID. This is. Oh no, I'm still working on the entities first. Dang it! I did all this for the wrong one! Okay. So we got that, we're writing out the component data, so it'd basically be right here, okay. So we're not talking about this, num keys, binary key map, that's about the same. Okay, component data sets, entity sets. This is pretty much the same, I guess. The entity ID, the entity editor name, the associated component data. Yeah. Okay. Should be the same thing. Good. Great. Oh, entity ID. Great. So, size of that. Times one from P file. So next would be editor name. So first things first, length is nothing yet because I haven't read it. F read. One key file. That's great. Then, if string length is greater than 0, editor name, editor name dot resize to be string length. And I want to do fread editor name dot data. So it's 1 byte times string length, key file. If what name map, not that, then I can do name map add. T name dot C string. Okay. Associate the component data. Now we're back down to here, right? No, first almost you went 32T out. File. I is less than component count plus I. Then we do that. So per component, then we do this. We got the entity ID, entity, great. We have the P simulation, that's great. Now we do that a whole bunch of times. This will return results. Result equals that if dot value not equals for success, then I'd want to do something along the lines of just return a result for now. Yeah, okay. Okay, I think that might work. Now, how many objects do I actually spit out of here? I don't know. Let's find out. After it compiles correctly, which it currently does not. I understand that. Thank you very much. Resource functions are not here anymore. Why are they not? Binary resource functions. Is that it? Okay, keep going. Great. Get to, where are we? If okay. Can't give an all. That. Thank you. Great. Easy. Okay, we got that. Great. We need to do the same thing on the resource side. Could be above it. Export resource. Do-do-do-do. There you are. Okay. Let's do this again. So I have how many? Four. I don't know what they are, but B77, 17F, B77, 17F, B77. Okay. Whatever they are. Back out of that. So I don't want to do that side, and I want to do the importer side where I'm going to be going through doing these things. I need to actually do that first, though. I need to. How do I do that? How do I create an importer? Sorry, not an importer. Simulation. Okay. Destroy that. Tests. Add name maps through. And test them. Make sure it actually does that. Water. Get state data, which is water. Name map, which is the test sim. Name map. Test sim. Okay, that's great. Then we want to do foe, destroy, simulation, test sim. Afterwards, I need to include. That. Get those functions in, right? Looks like. Maybe not. Oh, no conversion from simulation star to star star? Am I crazy? Oh. There we go. Okay. So we go inside of here. We go to right. The buffer's down here. I need to do that. Total data size minus equals size of. Thirty-two in length. Solve that. Minus that. Minus that. Minus the size of this. Then we get down to that. Looks about right. Okay, let's have a little go, shall we? Okay, total data size. We have 274 bytes. So to begin with, we have an entity which we are going to pull in, and it's going to be whatever the hell this is. Can I get this in binary? That's not helpful. Copy value. This is a very weird binary looking thing. Does not look good at all. Okay, tell you what. Let's. On the exporter side, I want to see the actual ID. I'm going to write that down. This is going to be some whack ID. Set ID is 375, 385. Is the end. This is the entity, right? Or is this? Yeah, this is component stuff. Resource ID, resource ID. Okay. Three 75, blah 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 blah, or 385. The last three characters, okay. To go all the way through, and then we abort at some point in here because we don't have the right data. Great. That is very not right. I'm lost somewhere else. Okay, this is total data size is 274. Hold on, let me make sure I'm actually on the right set. So it's entity data offset. Path to that. 274. Yeah, that's correct. That's the right size. I started off with the right offset, right? Offset minus entity data offset. No, yeah, that's right. So I'm at the right starting point. Am I missing total data written for this somewhere? That plus this. Maybe. The total written data is the same, right? Because I have the assert down here, yeah. So it's right. Binary key index. Am I missing? I'm not writing out the key length stuff, am I? No, I am not. That'll throw me off a little bit. For sure. Now, I am reading it correctly here, right? Key length, yeah, it's UN16. Okay, let's try that again. So it should still be 375, 385. Come back to this side. Run through. 375, 385. That's correct. Okay, we're back on track. So now we go through the point where we're having the string length stuff. There's no string length here for this thing, so we just increment it by 4, so 166. Oh yeah, no, that's because I'm going backwards. So yeah, back by 4. Yeah, okay. Yes, of course. And it doesn't crash. That is incredibly important. Okay, hold on. Let's see if it actually run through again. Perfect. It's importing the data correctly, I think. What a relief. Like just one small mistake is all that to throw the that's needed to throw it all off. Okay. Okay. I'm gonna grab a quick drink. I'll be right back to do the resource side of the import and then the files, I guess. So BRB. Okay. Now that I think about it, I don't actually think this is used at all, if I recall correctly. I'm pretty sure like the mass import was just kind of superseded by the fact that I could just import individual items instead, and I could do that in parallel, rather than in one large go serially, I could just do them in parallel. And I don't think I use this anymore. So let me just double check in here. Nope, here. Do I actually use this? And the answer is no. So let's not implement that. Don't need it. Not necessary. Not required. Not wanted. But I still need these. Now, how I'm writing this out isn't going to be conducive towards the reading of individual resources, their editor names, or the create info, because they're scattered all around the memory. If I want to get any individual piece, I need to start at the start, and I just need to, like, it literally just scan through memory. That isn't really great. So, what I'm thinking is I'm going to have to go with the idea of having basically like an index where at the beginning, so I have the binary key, and then after that, I'll have like the IDs mixed in with like offsets further into the file. So I can like very rapidly scan that smaller section of memory to find what I'm looking for, and then go further into memory to find individual items. That is probably going to be the best. So, let's get that going, shall we? And unfortunately, that's going to mean I need to make modifications to how I'm writing, exporting at least resources. I may do the same thing for entity data. I mean, the offset right now is what? UN32? So I'd spend an extra 32 bits or 4 bytes per entity per resource in the binary file to do this indexing. Is it worth it? I'll just implement it for the resources for now. Screw that. So, what do I need? When I'm exporting. Right. I'll need some more pieces for the, I can find it, the file header. Okay. Rather than the data offset, I need, like the UNTT resource. Resource index offset, I guess. Something like that. I don't know. I do not know. When I'm doing this, exporting resource data, I have the number of sets that make sense. Oh, right. And the names are embedded with the resource IDs as well. So I want to move that out so I can just have like a each resource index is a specific size so I can very quickly go through rather than having to kind of do some weird counting thing. So I need to put the name elsewhere down with the rest of the data. Offset. I need the offset. Which is going to be what? Resource sets. Okay. So what I need is like, current offset. Resource eyes, or would I even need that? Current offset, and then I need to return like something like this. I think. Okay. So when I'm exporting resource data, I have to start back here. So UN32T. Starts up at zero. Great. So what was it? 1, 2, 3. Told that, and you went 32. Something like that. Now what would happen is plus equals data size. So when I go inside of export resource, what it would be is current offset. And then what I want to do is T data size or resource size equals what? To T plus string length of, oh no, 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 I don't know if, if the resource name if that, and we add that. And then otherwise, we need to what? P binary sets size plus equals so with the string, then I need to add size of 32 for the count, and then resource data size plus equals set dot data size itself. No, hold on. The count. Okay, hold on. Name set count then this is the index data index UI data. Okay. Then star P resource size is resource data size. I think that's the layout I'm going to go with. Now, and that should mean that back at the resource ID, it's literally the resource ID and then offset. Yeah. Yeah. I hope. Okay. Rolling on back down to the point where we're writing this stuff out. It's got the resource ID, and then we'll have to add the offset. So I do need the resource. Binary key is first, then, okay. Index. Resource index. Offset. This is all kind of like. Yeah, I need better naming. But. Exporter. So what? First of all, resource. Okay, no, this is not that. This is the resource binary key index offset for this. Then, at this point, we're not write out resource index. And then, afterwards, so binary file header dot resource index offset is FL, where I am, PL file. It's not that. It'll be this plus f write step dot size of one d out file. This is increased a little bit. Cleaning the side of the crash. Very good. Resource sets I. Data iterator doesn't happen until here. So that and that. Times however many. And then here, file header data dot resource. It FTEL P out file. Okay. Which begins with the resource editor name and then the associated resource CIs. So the count. The number of data sets. Okay, hold on. That's not right, is it? Can I split this off to the right? So I can go back up to here. Entity set, resource. Okay. So here we've got the name length, the name, the set count. The set count is 32. Then the index is 16. Then we have size, which is another 32. Okay. And then you got the data. That's how much this is increasing each time. Okay. Maybe not. May okay. Yeah, just yeah. So we got what? We got 'set name size. That's great. Hundred and 28 bytes because the name length. Let me actually just count this up. P resource name is non-boned whatever. So you got 4, 18, 22, 24, 28. The data size, which takes us to 128. Okay. And we leave. We have the data size returned as 128, so total resource data size increases by that much. That's the offset into the data section for resources that all this 128 bytes is, which is zero. The next one will be. And 69, 128. We just check P resource sets. Okay. Can I? Go in 120. Okay, offset is 0, offset 128. There's one data set. That's great. Okay. So back onto the importer again. Getting the resource. Okay, first of all, let's get started here where we do this. Get down to this point. That's great. I need to pause and reopen the window. BRB. Okay, it's coming back alive. Great. Here, save it. And we're back in business. Okay. Start to end. Entry size. Could be the size of a full resource ID and the size of a UN32T for now. That means equals what? It's not that, it's resource. Index offset. We're going from the next section. So it's P importer header dot resource data offset minus that. And this section size mod entry size equals 0. Do I need this? No. Do I need this? No. I'm not reading that kind of stuff. I'm just reading Plain old data. I need this, though. Because what I'm doing right now is, I'm just, it's one of these, right? Yeah, so if I don't actually have name, I'm just returning, yeah, okay. How do I read this? How do I do this? I don't know. Okay, let's just do it sequentially right now. So while section red size, we'll just kind of have like. Less than section size. This is horribly inefficient. I hate myself. But it must be done. So I'm gonna go through, I'm just gonna like F read sequentially until I find it. Ugh. Yeah, okay. Resource ID, one, the file. If Right, because these are only local ones. Foe ID, get value, get index. Resource equals resource index ID. Okay, I need to do that. Split index slash group for what? Binary. Okay. Right back to this. If those match, then we get to do something else. Otherwise, and then we'd return, get out, and then we'd return something like that. Then we'd break. No. Then we want to F read. Data offset. We'd want to do that. No. I just want this. Size of UN32T 1 the file. We want to break out of here. Otherwise, we want to fseek forward in the file. my size of EN32T. Seek current. Okay. We'd move forward by X number of bytes, and we'd just repeat it again. Oh, and I need to read size. Do that. If not found, the result binary error fail to find. Resource data, or whatever it was, something like that. Otherwise, we can then fseek to the point that we're looking for. So I need to fseek np file from the seek set from the start of it. I need to go to pimporter file header dot resource data offset plus dire data offset. You went 32T string length. F read by n string length. 1. If p name is null pointer, then we're just going to be returning, yeah, string. That. Otherwise, then we're going up to the point. It'd be that or that plus one. Plus one. Because I want to also do the No, what if it's zero? What if I have a name length of zero? Then a null pointer will satisfy just fine. Okay. If this is less than string length, one, then it'll be incomplete. results will be incomplete. Otherwise, we copy the whole thing. Okay, yeah. If that's less, yeah. P name, P star, P name length, one, file. Binary incomplete. Now I may actually have to do that instead. I don't recall why. It may, it's probably important. Otherwise, I need that. I need to put that up here in results. I think. Let's see how it's going to work. So I gotta do star supermodel kilobyte. Get a resource. Name for resource ID is, I don't know. Okay, what is the first thing I put away? Let me get the exact one. Resource, editor name right here. Here we go. I'm just gonna copy and paste it. So, the first one I'm putting away for this set is nothing. That is, oh no, sorry, is that. So, I need, what is the ID? ID of one. Okay, that should be doable. Let's find out, shall we? How does that roll? Cool, don't care about that side anymore. I want to go to this side, which failed horribly. Why? We are on the importer side, that's correct. Size of this. Group index data. Interesting. 554 is because of the size of the thing has changed. Right? Get group index data. These have changed. Entity index is no longer based on that. It's based on the resource binary key index offset. That's the new ending point of that. Okay, we're here. Great. So entry size is 8 bytes. 4 plus 4. Yeah, okay, that makes sense. We have section size of 136 divided by that. Okay, great. Resize equals 0. So the first one we get is 1. We found it. Great. Going to get the offset, and that's going to be 0. Great. So that's that. We get that. That's string length. We print that out. Great. Must be a reuse from something else. Non-boned mesh plus that turns us to here where super buffer is now non-boned mesh 0. Yes, I like that. Okay, what about 2? I don't know what 2 is. We'll find out. So one of them was unboned mesh. The next one was boned mesh. Okay. Boned mesh. And it works. Okay, great. Fantastic. Now, in a very similar fashion, I want to get the data. Just very, very close to the same thing. So we got this stuff. We go down to this point where we're reading all the stuff. We want to do down to this point. We seek down to that, okay. And then ID. Okay, this is slightly different. F equals that, great. We get down to this point. We're seeking. Okay, great. Then we read the string length, or rather, we seek past it. So I can actually, no, I can seek. Seek past the because I don't know the length of how far I need to seek. So past the current. Okay, great. So now we're at the data point. So now we've got to do data count. First of all, assert data count is equal to 1 right now. Yeah, okay. So we got that. Now going back to the exporter, let me double check. So that's the data count. We're going to need to get, okay, the key index. Unit 16T. That's 1, key file. If no, then we read the size. So this will be 4 kilobytes, 4096 for now. Be updated later. I just want to read the buffer, and I want to check the size. Sorry, not 496, data size times 1 p file. Okay, so I have that. Now I need to have key. Did I not? I didn't read in the binary key yet. Which would look something like this. So I need to do this part first. Get rid of that, get rid of that, get rid of this, get rid of this. So this is getting the key map, so I need to seek to source binary key index offset. Okay, key length, blah, 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 blah. I have the map right there. There's the key map. So rolling on down to here, I need to do equals the key map dot sorry, not that. What am I getting? Standard string view equals tmap dot. Sorry, this. Which iterator equals? I need to grab the this stuff. Here at this point. Get resource functions, resource functions. Find key if iterator equals resource functions dot end. We've got a bit of a problem. We'll abort. Otherwise, we found it, so we're gonna create the create info. Be down to around here. Okay. Resource. Sorry, not that. Result equals. I don't have a result yet. Okay. Search iterator dot second dot import function time, which so it's the data, so it's buffer times data size. Okay, I want to see like let's end that. Do I have the translator? I must have the translator, right? From it's part of the importer, isn't it? Resource CI. If that otherwise equals two for result, binary out of memory, I guess. I'll just kind of throw that out there for the moment. RP resource creating resource CI. Water, go with let's say resource two, If create info, then we'll just kind of destroy source create info. Okay, that's see how that goes. Do I even reach this point or do I fail? Okay, I'm here. So I have a data count of 1. That's good. Key index, which is going to be of 0, I guess. So, okay, it's a boned, it's a vertex descriptor. I know that. It's a boned vertex descriptor. So get the buffer, the data size is about 144 bytes. That's okay. That looks about right. So key map, key index is 41 something, blah, blah, blah. This takes us here. Search iterator for the second thing is import vertex descriptor create info. Yes. Yes, 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 yes. Success. I create it. I return out. Yeah. Yes. Okay. Music. Okay. So that only really leaves one item left. Which is the external file. Finding the external file, which is no longer technically external, it's internal to this. But not entirely sure. I'm just, oh yeah, okay, hold on. This is going to require a bunch more work throughout everything because if I recall correctly, this is still based entirely on returning a path, which I can't do because, you know, it's not that. It's literally a file. For that, and it's in memory for this. Is that even worth it? I could just take the data, put it out as a temporary file, and then read that? Like the temporary folder or temporary directory? I don't know. You know what? That sounds like something I'll do next time. I've done enough. I'm tired. Making mistakes. I'm slowing down. So that just leaves that for next time. External file. Probably a bunch of reworking for the old stuff as well. Or something. Or a temporary solution which creates a file in a temporary directory and then reads that instead of something like that. Maybe. Maybe. I don't know. So that's next time. This time, whatever. So until next time, cheers.